hockey fans, we've got a busy night with 10 action-packed games on the docket. The Rangers welcomed back a couple of ex-teammates wearing Wild jerseys, but the crowd at MSG was showing love in a different kind of way. We'll explain. How do you respond to a three-goal deficit? Well, how about three goals of your own? You won't believe what happened in the first period between the Canucks and Penguins. And the hottest team in the NHL right now? That would be the Seattle Kraken. They were in Buffalo looking for a sixth straight win. I'm Jamie Hirsch, and we've got all that and more as On the Fly starts now. Tuesday marked the halfway point of the season for the Hurricanes and Devils, who went head-to-head in Raleigh, separated by just 4 points atop the Metro. No doubt this is going to be an epic fight to the finish in the best division in hockey, with the Capitals and Rangers right behind Jersey. The Devils looked like they were going to run away with the division earlier this season, but the Canes took over first place with a win against New Jersey on December 20th and haven't let up since. On Tuesday, things got crazy pretty quickly in Raleigh, so let's get to the highlights.
We know how loaded and crowded the Metro's been. All season long, the Devils and Canes have each made their runs. We hit the midway point now.
This sets up to be an outstanding match.
The Devils load up a second power play. Face off to the left of Vanacek. Quick win for the Canes. They score! Yes, Barry Kotkaniemi off the draw. And Carolina strikes first here at home. Seventh of the season for Jesperi Kotkaniemi. When they get goals early on, well, that's been part of the story, and they've been really good in first periods.
Absolutely.
David Thaw lugs it around Burns from a sharp angle. Kochetkov trying to locate it, and a whistle stops play. We are going to have a look at this to see if Jonas Siegenthaler snuck it past Fyodor Kochetkov.
And that looks to be over the goal line from that perspective.
After a video review, it was determined that the puck fully crossed the goal line, therefore this is a goal.
A big-time play by Siegenthaler for the equalizer.
So that does it for the first 20 here in Raleigh. Vitek Vanacek and the Devils on the road in a 1-1 game.
And to play this style, you've got to be in outstanding condition, which the Canes are.
Pacioretty just in toward the net. They score. Seth Jarvis was parked out in front. Pacioretty chipped it in his direction. And off the ricochet, the Canes strike and grab the lead. Hughes has been all over the place positionally on this power play. Carried out by Aho, shorthanded. His pass gets it back, and Aho scores. Second shorty tonight for Carolina, and it's Sebastian Aho who makes it a two-goal lead for the Canes.
Aho, nice interchange between him and Teravainen, and that's a slam dunk for Aho.
Here's Mercer, hounded by Martinuk from behind. Mercer still with it, working to the backhand, and Mercer scores. The Devils get one right back and trim the margin back to one.
And there's Mercer hunting this down, winning the possession, taking it strong to the cage.
Our second goal in this last 1:34 stretch. And now inside of a minute. And now to the backhand.
Oh.
Bergwijn scores! This game is tied!
Wow! The Devils coming all the way back to tie this one. Nice little interchange. And watch the strong take again by Boqvist. Great agility on his edges. Threads this one through the five hole. Two goals in 18 seconds for the NJD. Wow, what a turn of events here in NC.
The Devils, they tied it. How about that? Gorgeous opportunity for the Devils, who race right back in. Mercer to the forehand. Score! Dawson Mercer second. It's three in a row for the Devils, who lead on the road.
Oh my goodness. Dawson Mercer splits the D. Backhand, forehand. What a goal by Dawson Mercer. He's absolutely stunned. This amazing atmosphere here in Raleigh, North Carolina.
And Tatar skates it out. Heischer's got it. Heischer into the zone. And Heischer missed the net. Draws a penalty.
And he's making a clinch. Now will they give this to him?
The Jersey player is on the breakaway with an open net. He gets hooked by number 11. So it's a goal.
There it is.
And the Devils win it in comeback fashion on the road. Back-to-back multi-goal comeback wins for the first time since 2001. 4 points separated these teams at the start of the night. Now it's a two-point margin.
How about that? The Devils battled back from a 3-1 deficit to defeat the Canes for their league-leading fifth multi-goal comeback win of the season and second in as many games. Dawson Mercer scored twice, including the game winner, marking his first career multi-goal game. And Nico Hischier extended his point streak to 8 straight. Afterward, Jack Hughes spoke about the great team win.
You know, when your third line wins you the game, that's big. That's huge for our confidence, and, you know, it's a big team win, so... you know, they had a great game. We're really happy for Merce.
Listen, NJD's a serious threat in the National this year. Let's hear your thoughts on it.
No, yeah, I think that's game 41 for us. So that's a really good first half for us. And, you know, I think we're pretty excited about what we have in that locker room. And we just got to keep moving forward. And, you know, we're pretty pumped up for this Cali trip and hopefully get some wins out there.
On to the second half. Well, the Devils have had some issues on home ice recently, but they've been dominant on the road all season long. New Jersey is now 15-2-1 away from home and has the best road points percentage in the NHL. This is the fastest the Devils have reached 15 road wins in a season in franchise history. Elsewhere in the Metro, the Rangers were hosting the Wild in New York City.
And Ryan Reeves is getting a welcome back to New York.
Nice ovation from the crowd.
All the treats you need to have an outstanding line. Size, shot.
Oh, what a glove save by Fleury. He slides across to Rob Kocko.
Foligno for Greenway in the corner. Greenway fights off a check. Maintains the puck. Got it back to Foligno and a shot was blocked. Merrill fires. He scores! John Merrill fires from the circle. And the grief line strikes for Minnesota. The Wild on the board first.
And really important, the screen in front of the net. I'm sure Shesterkin did not see that puck as you had Ek coming across while the shot's coming and Foligno right in front.
Kocko lost it to Reeves. He gives to Steele. Across for Kaprizov. Kaprizov scores! He beats Shesterkin up over the shoulder.
Recent goal scoring by Kaprizov. How many has he done in the upper corner like that, so quick, the short side, the far side, he gets it away so fast and so hard, goaltender can't react.
That's poked away, good play by BC, racing for it, it's Miller. Miller gets to the net, he scores! What an effort by Keandre Miller! Rangers break through to cut it to 2-1.
Miller uses his speed, uses his strength to protect the puck, and then the skill that we talked about to finish.
Talked about Gauthier being out. Here's what happens.
Ooh.
Boy, he got hammered from both sides. Hayne on one side, Ryan Reeves on the other. Played less than 2 minutes in the first period and has not returned.
Both Panarin and Miller, they thought the other player was going to get the pass, and now Fox makes a play.
Fox with Trocheck, 2-on-1. Fox shoots. It's got to feel real good as the game is tied, 2-2.
And Steele scoops it up. He goes cross-ice to Zuccarello. Zuccarello moves in for a shot. Saves Shesterkin. Yes. He scores!
Off the glove of Shesterkin, and it flutters over the top of the Ranger goaltender. And Zuccarello has Minnesota in front, 3-2.
And a great pass by Steele getting that puck across. Shesterkin just missed that one. Excellent shot by Zuccarello up high.
Look at that hit by Foligno, Joe. Yeah, you could tell he was holding that arm down as he got to the bench, had a conversation with Jim Ramsey, and went to the Rangers locker room.
Out to Goodrow. Rangers moving well. Fox is in. And the scrambling in the crease.
And
score!
Let's see. Puts it in there. I think it goes off the skate of Dumba. I think Fox is going to get it.
Panarin, 3-for-3 this season. Brings it in, and he scores! Goodrow will try to tie it for Minnesota. If Shesterkin stops him, it's over. Goodrow moves in, and it's over! Rangers win!
How about that? The Rangers Rangers get the win in a wild game that needed extra time. Defenseman Adam Fox and Keandre Miller both get a goal and an assist in the victory. But it's Artemi Panarin who scores the winner in the shootout. As for the Wild, this is the second time they've dropped three straight contests this season. Rangers head coach Gerard Gallant spoke about his team's clutch performance.
I felt real good about our game tonight. For the most part, it was a real good, solid game, and, you know, so good, solid effort from our group.
Yeah, I like when he shoots the puck. He shoots it pretty good. I mean, that slap shot was a great shot on Fleury, caught him up high, and then the goal, obviously, so keep shooting the puck. He's got to shoot the puck more. I've always said that, but he's pretty good when he passes it, too, so I'm not going to mess around with his game. Yeah, no, we had that power play in OT and didn't get it down there. We had a couple of looks at it and didn't score, but fortunately for us, Red Man's pretty good in the shootout, and Kaapo Kakko was pretty good. So, you know, I thought we deserved to win that hockey game the way we played.
And with that, the Rangers' turnaround continues. New York has won 12 of its last 16 games and has earned points in six straight. After a lackluster start, the Blue Shirts are right back in the thick of the Metro Division race halfway through the season. Next up, they have a date with the Stars at MSG on Thursday. And just 18 miles away, those Stars were taking on the Islanders.
So the Stars 41 down, 41 to go, but they do face an obstacle here on the road as their number one center, Roope Hintz, is not on the trip. So that creates a ripple effect, and it puts a spotlight on Tyler Seguin, Razor, who's elevated in the middle of that top line. So the Stars may be trying to get a quick start. Here's Pavelski in front, a chance, Robertson, he scores! Jason Robertson, who had two goals in the last game, opens up the scoring here with number 29 on the year. Anders Lee's there, but he's being held by Lindell out high. Dobson, Nelson, slap pass back door, they score! Anders Lee, it's a power play goal for the Islanders. They tied it at one.
The passing was pretty. The finish, a little suspect. Bottom line, they got the job done. Huge goal for the Islanders. Gets themselves back into this game at 1-1.
To center ice, and then grabbed by Nelson. He walks in left circle, and a shot just missed the right post.
Man, that happened quick. Esa Lindell got caught up in neutral ice. Not a lot of forward help. They're very fortunate this isn't 2-1.
Out high, Suter just barely keeps it ahead of the blue line. Cross ice feed, shot gets blocked. Sorokin goes down, trying to locate it. Wraparound chance, Sorokin got the pad out.
Whenever the puck's bouncing around, you're not sure who's got it, who's going to get it. And look at Sorokin. He was a little bit extended to his left side all the way around and then get that foot over there. And then on the outside, kicks the puck loose.
When they've struggled, but especially these last two games, the back-to-back losses, 4-2 and 4-1 defeats. Here's Ben with a shot. Sorokin the save and the rebound.
Islanders were trying to work it out of their own zone. It hits the linesman. The goalies have been really busy. They've been the stars of the third period.
10 seconds to go. Parisi has Mayfield. Scott Mayfield shoots one off Oettinger. Bailey with the keep. In front, Parisi, the redirection, and Oettinger swallows it up.
And it's all about the Islanders. Parisi over to Mayfield. There's a shot. Look at the aggressive nature right there of Oettinger. And then Ryan Pullock's going to come right down the middle as he's going to get a shot. There's a deflection right there.
We are headed to overtime. So the Isles get a point. Stars do as well. One more still out there. He hands for Lindell. Back for Gurianov. In he comes. Gurianov turned aside by Sorokin. And what a 3-on-3 as it comes to a close. Still undecided.
The goalies have lived up to the billing.
Jason Robertson.
He loves going first.
He does. One-on-one against Sorokin. Starts wide to the left. Curls back in. Scores. Gorgeous shot.
Once he got down and that glove was dropped, he just went over top of the glove hand.
Brock Nelson trying to extend this beyond three rounds. Needs a goal for the Islanders. Nelson on Oettinger. Saved by Oettinger. Perfect in the shootout. Brilliant in the game. And the Stars get a 2-1 shootout victory.
Another New York team, another shootout. But it's the Stars who come out victorious at UBS Arena on Tuesday. Jason Robertson scored the lone goal for Dallas in regulation, giving him goals in back-to-back contests. And he netted the winner in the shootout as well. Jake Oettinger recorded his 60th career win on Tuesday, stopping 26 of the 27 shots he faced in regulation and overtime, plus three more in the shootout. Oettinger reached the 60-win mark in 107 games, which is the second fastest in franchise history, behind only Hall of Famer Ed Belfour. The Canucks came out blazing, and the Penguins looked on their way to starting another losing streak. But that was until Malkin and Crosby had their say in the matter. Highlights of a wild one in Pittsburgh next. Five-game winning streak, 26 goals over that span for the Kraken.
That's Kraken hockey, baby. A shot, he scores! What a bullet! Another total team effort.
They played exactly how they're supposed to, and they continue that. They're going to be a hard team to beat.
Their top two lines are terrific players up and down. Their defense is top five in scoring goals. So they have as much depth scoring as any team in the league. Team defense is quite good. That's why this team's in a playoff spot. That's why this team should be a playoff team in just their second year of existence.
Well, chances are you didn't have the Kraken Sabres matchup circled on your calendar a few months ago as must-see TV, but these two teams have been lighting it up lately. Long gone are the days of Seattle as an expansion team just struggling to be competitive on a nightly basis. Yeah, in year two, the Kraken suddenly look like a legit playoff team. They enter Tuesday on a five-game winning streak, outscoring their opponents 26-8 over that stretch. But they would have their hands full with a resurgent team in Buffalo, so let's head there now for the highlights.
Skinner at center ice trying to touch that one ahead. Thompson works his way around one. Can't get right for the shot. It was on his backhand. Kraken intercept. They've got a three-man rush pushing. Wenberg center. Schwartz at the near post. And Comrie got over. Keep that one out. We'll play it out of the wing. Skinner, Thompson in the middle. Stays with it. Thompson makes a move on Larson to the net. Thompson feeding Alex Tuck. And it's 1-0 Buffalo.
And he's going wide. He knows he's not getting that puck to the net, but he can slide it across. He's got Tuck coming in on the offside, and he just taps it in right here.
Buffalo number 37, two-minute minor for holding.
Muckle Shoot Casino power play for the Kraken. Burakovsky tipped in. Jordan Eberle out in front. Andre Burakovsky just said, hey, I'll throw it at the net. And those sick mitts of Eberle are right there, and the Kraken have tied it.
And 5-0-7.
Sabres win the draw right away down the middle. Scores! Rasmus Dahlin took the shot. I don't know if that was deflected in front. The Sabres lead it 2-1 with a quick power play goal.
Watch Skinner just kind of swipe at it with a stick there, and it kind of threw Grubauer off a little bit. It's going to find its way into the back of the net. Dahlin's going to collect his 13th goal of this season.
Schultz out in front. They score! Yanni Gourde! That's hockey, baby! What a pass! By Justin Schultz, and the Pepper Pockets a twig to it, and the Kraken have tied it again. Then he'll cut, shoot one, block, he gets it back, Tuck, pads on it, at the side of the goal, then off the panel of Grubauer, from Tuck, Thompson goes across, Skinner, Grubauer says no, a couple of times. The German gentleman at his best right here, robbing Skinner twice. 60 seconds gone in the third. Burakovsky to the outside of power. He'll sauce it for Dunn. Off the post, they score! Hey, hey, what do you say? Matty Beniers is right there for the cash. That's with Adam Larson. Here's a chance straight away, a bouncing puck. Grubauer says no on Victor Olofsson.
Grubauer's able to stay strong, cover it up, no rebound in front.
Here's a turnover. Tanev sends it to the far post. Pad save by Comrie.
He's kind of carelessly threw this puck out to the front here, and Kraken's right on top of it, and they miss it on the far side.
Eberle downstairs, let it go for Beniers to the slot. They score! Justin Schultz hits it right on the screws, and he gets a beautiful pass from Matty Beniers.
And the puck finds itself right back in that high slot area. Great one-timing option.
Skinner knocks it down. That's gloved outside the line by Gourde. Oh, and a big collision as Dahlin. It's
Tanev.
Tanev sat down.
He comes across. Great hit, shoulder to shoulder. Tanev gets up, comes back at him, and everybody got in there pretty quick.
Back to Dahlin. Slapper rebound. No celebration at all. Larson with Tanev. The Kraken get it out. Time will expire. The Kraken have won six in a row.
Yeah, the Kraken are unstoppable again. With the 4-3 win over the Sabres on Tuesday, Seattle makes it six wins in a row. Andre Burakovsky extends his point streak to four games, while All-Star Matty Beniers scores his 16th of the season. That's the most among all rookies in the league. Afterward, Justin Schultz credited his team's consistency on the ice.
This group's good at just going day by day and, you know, just worrying about the game at hand and the shift at hand. And it's been working for us, so now we're on to Boston. Yeah, well, our forwards have been doing a great job of forechecking, using their speed, and we're just playing well as a team right now. But we can't get complacent here. We got to keep it going. And he's got elite skill, great vision, kind of has it all. He works hard, and it's a pleasure to play with him. Obviously, he can find you in spots like that. It's nice.
Yeah, the Kraken have won six straight games for the second time now, joining the Bruins as the only teams with multiple six-game win streaks this season. Seattle has won each of the first five games of a season-long seven-game road trip, and rookie Matty Beniers scored for a franchise record fifth straight game. Off to another high-scoring affair with the Canucks and Penguins in Pittsburgh.
The Penguins were flying out of Arizona, but not to come to Pittsburgh. In fact, they flew to Montreal so the team could attend Chris Letang's father's funeral. Letang's still not with the team, but you know that move and the support shown to him by his teammates meant the world.
Center tip to the middle, and here's a chance for Bluger. Cutting in, he shoots Martin to save, and the rebound cleared to the side. Now Quinn Hughes starts up. Pass to Garland, who's in on the left wing with some room. Connor Garland shoots, he scores! Martin with a save at one end, and Garland a dash down the left wing to open the scoring for Vancouver. And he gets a shot on goal, now chips the puck right in front, chance for Besser, he scores on the backhand. And the Canucks with goals on two of their first four shots have taken a 2-0 lead.
Game winner against Colorado.
Here's a shot from the line, and it's in!
Elias Pettersson gets it back, long wrister through the maze, and it does. Here's the traffic in front, off his stick, off his arm, and squeaks in.
And there's going to be a goalie change for Pittsburgh.
Dustin Tokarski is going to make his Penguin debut. There's a lot of time left in this game for a team in the Canucks who gives up so many goals. Penguins off this faceoff, 5-on-3. Malkin, the drive, he scores! Evgeny Malkin, the no-doubt blast at 3-1. Crosby's got a chance, sweeps it back up high. Dumoulin and redirected and scores! Sidney Crosby! There he is, 87 with the stick on the ice, and Brian Dumoulin put it right there. Well, until you make that team commitment to play defense.
Off the faceoff! Jason Zucker, we are tied at 3!
Canucks the first three, the Penguins the last three.
Everybody's having a fun night tonight, except the goaltenders.
Payad, rip the puck, Malkin starts his way in. Zucker dangles on the Malkin. Pads of Martin and the Canucks locate the rebound. Tokarski hesitates and it's a chance for Pettersson. Dangles in and Tokarski shut the door.
He got a toe on it, did he not?
Highsmith to Malkin. Slap shot and Raquel, he scores. Raquel says thank you very much.
And it drops out of the laundry of Raquel and he puts it into the wide open net.
1 minute and 46 seconds into the game. The Canucks score three times to 218. Fancy moving tight by Pettersson. Shut down again by Tokarski. The jam away in the crease. Still no whistle. Scramble continues. It comes up high. Tokarski makes the save.
Without a glove? I think he made a save without his glove on.
Ridiculous stop from Dustin Tokarski.
Here's Ekman Larson again. Another shot missed to that. Rebound, Dermott. No, he scored. Pardon me. Travis Dermott on the backhand. I thought Tokarski had come across with a glove for a moment, but the Canucks end the run of five straight Pittsburgh goals.
But that's in the net. Even if it's in his glove, it's in the net.
And sends it off the glass and down. It's rolling towards the empty net. Fisher makes the save just in the nick of time. Might we be talking about that one at night champ.
Defended by Dumoulin, fired across Besser. Now it's Pettersson. Pettersson with the shot, missed the net. Centering pass in front. And that's stand away by Gensel. And this one is over. Dustin Tokarski, third Pens goalie all time to earn a win off the bench in his team debut.
What a game in Pittsburgh. The Pens get their second straight win thanks to an outstanding game from Evgeny Malkin and their big stars. Malkin collects 4 points on the night for the first time this season, and both Ty Smith and Jason Zucker finished with 2 points apiece to help secure the victory. After the game, Zucker spoke about the comeback.
Yeah, but, you know, we can't take moral victories. You know, we got to make sure that we're getting points and scoring goals and winning these games. So for us, it didn't matter if we were playing better or not. We were down 3-0, so we had to come back and grind. And it was nice to have it tied up after one.
I didn't get the feeling that we were expecting it to. We got the lead, and anytime you jump out to an early lead like that, you sort of relax a little bit. And once they caught fire, I mean, they were pretty dangerous the rest of the period. But I thought at the end of the period, okay, great. You know, I mean, they had 20 shots. We weathered the storm a little bit if it's coming out tied after the one period. And I thought if we could regroup, and we would be able to muster up something else.
So the Penguins gave up 3 goals in the first 8 minutes, but scored 3 of their own to head into the first intermission all square. For just the 3rd time in franchise history, the Pens erased a 3-goal deficit in the first period to at least tie the game. Pittsburgh became the 9th different club to report a 3-goal comeback victory this season. Now to Detroit, where the Jets would attempt a comeback of their own.
Goes for the former Jet, caught to the line for Sider. Across for his defense partner, Wallman, with a good move to get away. Wallman in the shot, he scores! Red Wings strike first.
What a move by Wallman, just inside the Jets' blue line.
In behind for Kopp again. Wallman moves to the middle. Pavek scores! Bergeron! Kopp's got a night going against his former team, and it's 2-0.
And boy, he made no mistake in burying that baby in the top corner.
Back here for Raymond to Sider. In front of the goal, Sundquist scores! Sider's got 3 assists. Sundquist got the goal.
He went right between the legs of the defenseman.
Shifley. Red Wings keeping him on the exterior. There's a shot. Pionk scores. After all that possession time, Pionk drills it at a career-high 7th goal for Neil Pionk, and obviously much needed for the Jets.
Round it goes for Johnson Pialdi. Back out to center now. Sundquist busting in. Sundquist, that puck scores! Kubalik! Boy, is that ever needed for him! And the Red Wings have restored a 3-goal lead.
Stops, sets it up. Johnson Pialdi with a rocket. Now grab their center pass. Score! It is returned to Detroit, and it's 4-2 Red Wings. So Gagne with his 8th perfetti as Shifley works to get open in front. Here's a chance, they score! Schmidt off the blue line, into the net, and it's 4-3. Nate Schmidt with his 4th goal of the season, and what a read by him.
Raymond, great pass, Sider, Larkin, scores!
Talk about Christmas in January. Doubted the other 3. And here comes Nikolai Ehlers to a one shoot, scores! Bingo! Ehlers between the legs. And once again, it's a 1-goal game.
Has some room. Back now to Lindstrom. Tip to front. Scores! What a great play for Fabry! Bobby Fabry makes it 6-4.
Took a chance, why not? To Wall with a quick shot off the post. Lucy scores! And it's Shifley on the power play, and it's a 1-goal game with 5 minutes left.
What a great play.
Off Ehlers, empty net here for Larkin. Larkin ahead for Raymond. That'll seal it. 7-5.
Much needed win if it's going to be with a minute and 20 to go. Hellebuck's back in.
Dillon now with 35 points. His 21st assist, 11th goal for Raymond.
The Jets have been grounded. The Wings get a huge 7-5 win to snap their own small losing skid in Winnipeg on Tuesday. Mo Sider is the star of the show as he records 4 helpers in the game. Lucas Raymond also had 3 points, including the empty netter, to ensure the Jets could not complete the comeback. Sider entered Tuesday's game with just 2 points in his last 17, but he broke out of that slump in a big way, recording 4 assists in this win. His 4 helpers tied the Red Wings franchise record for most assists in a game by a defenseman, and he's just the 4th Detroit D-man to accomplish that feat since 2000. Coming up, the Panthers drew first blood against the Avs in a battle between the top 2 teams in last year's standings. We'll head to Colorado, where this season both clubs are fighting just to make the playoffs.
run right back and trim the margin back to one. Wow!
The Devils coming all the way back to tie this one.
Dawson Mercer second. It's three in a row for the Devils, who lead on the road.
Been a long time for Adam Fox. That's got to feel real good. Fox is in.
He scores!
Panarin, 3-for-3 this season.
He scores!
In front of the goal, Sundquist scores! Sider's got 3 assists. Sundquist got the goal.
Everything they shoot going in the net.
The pass, Sider, Larkin.
Sider has 4 assists.
Hey, hey, what do you say? Matty Beniers is right there for the cash. Justin Schultz hits it right on the screws from Matty Beniers.
Evgeny Malkin, Dino Beast Mode, and it's 4-3. Record Raquel says thank you very much, and this one is over.
Evgeny Malkin scored twice and added 2 helpers in Pittsburgh's win over Vancouver, becoming just the 3rd Penguins player in the past 15 years to register a 4-point game at age 36 or older. It marks the 28th 4-point game of Malkin's career, which is the 4th most among active players. Now we're off to St. Louis for the Flames and the Blues.
3-5-on-3 as the Blues walk onto center ice with Thomas. And Shen will come on the ice now for Santini.
Up Kyrou to Buchnevich, right in front. He scores! Buchnevich! It was tipped, and the Blues a power play goal, and they lead 1-0.
Long pass fed ahead up the near side. In comes Walker, backhanded in front, and Markstrom makes the save. Tipped on goal by Neighbors. Markstrom able to hang on. Kept onside by Mikola. Now Zadorov kicks it ahead to Lucic. And he feeds Huberdeau. Now Kadri out in front. They score! Lucic on the setup by Kadri. What a pass! And Milan Lucic with the finish ties this game at 1. Huberdeau taken down. Play continues. Looks like Tucker got a stick in the feet of Huberdeau. No call. They score! Tipped in front. Backlund on the redirection after the shot by Zadorov. And it's 2-1 Calgary. Here's Hanifin trying to get it in front. Now he does. Backlund's there. Binnington's down. It winds up going wide. Hanifin. Mangiapane scores. Andrew Mangiapane able to put it home. And the Flames early second period go up 3-1. And now Kadri feeds Huberdeau. Pass across to Foley. Off the crossbar with a quick wrist shot.
This one went off the glove and then off the crossbar and out.
Kuzuchka slow to get back to the Calgary bench as Neighbors comes ahead. Now for Santini. From the boards, a shot on goal, rebound. They score! Alexandrov! And it's 3-2. That was a classic example of just taking a harmless shot that really Markstrom should have handled better. But Alexander goes to the net and he knocks it in, and it's 3-2.
Sometimes it's a hot potato. You don't know. Can't take it for granted. Got to go to the net.
A toe drag and a shot. And he scores!
Tipped.
And now Kyrou gets it. And he waits, trying to make a play to Buchnevich. In front, a shot. They score!
I believe that this is going to be challenged for offside on the entry by Kyrou. The linesmen have to decide whether or not they feel he had possession of that puck or not. And I don't believe he did.
Upon video review, the play was offside. Therefore, we have no goal.
Boy, a tough break for the Blues. Drops it off to Kadri. He comes in with speed to Huberdeau. In front, knocked away by Falk, and the Blues at 2-on-1. Kyrou and Thomas, here they come. Kyrou to Thomas. He scores! That's all, folks. Blues win.
The defenseman prematurely goes towards Kyrou. That's what he wanted. And then a beautiful shot by Thomas under the bar and in the net for the game-winning goal.
He had one called back in the third period. They don't call this one back. It is a game winner.
Overtime was needed to decide the winner in this one, and the Blues get the extra point. Robert Thomas secures the 11th game-winning goal of his career, and Jordan Kyrou picks up 3 points on the night for the 3rd time this season. The Flames have now lost 3 of their last 4 contests. St. Louis was down 3-1 heading into the final frame, but the Blues scored 2 goals to tie it up and force overtime, and then finished it during the extra frame. It was the Blues' third multi-goal, third-period comeback win of the season. That's tied for the most in the NHL. And St. Louis has now won four of its last five overall. Now we're off to Colorado for the Panthers and Avalanche.
Here comes Anton Lundell. He'll chip and chase, but his teammates are changing. Lundell in front. Puck loose, backhand score. Alexander Barkov off the bench into the net. His 10th goal of the year. The Panthers lead 1-0. Back comes Verhaeghe. Drops it back to Montour. Score! Brandon Montour. Bar down, hands up. Mama cries. It's 2-0 Panthers. Panthers power play has been pretty good of late. Four of their last 12.
Meanwhile, the Blues picked up an important overtime win over the Flames to inch closer to that final wild card spot, and the Stars win in a shootout to stay atop the Central. With 23 points in his last 10 games against Columbus, Nikita Kucherov simply owns the Blue Jackets. How many points did he add to that total? Find out next. Welcome back to On the Fly. Let's head down to Tampa for the Blue Jackets and Lightning.
Back across the grain, he's picked off, and it's quickly moved up ahead. Hagel, right side, curls back, beats the late man, Chernak down low, tip, scores! Nikita Kucherov opens the scoring early, and it's 1-0 Lightning.
What a shift by Nikita Kucherov.
Hedman, Kucherov winds and fires a shot. That was blocked as well.
Branson again.
Kucherov again. He is firing. Tip scores! Tipped right in front.
available, redirects it, five hole, Mullaney, you're up 2-0.
Ross pulling up top to Patrick Laine. Laine, snap shot just wide. Ross Laine ends up back with Babe Ruther. Wise fires, scores! Babe Ruther with the shot, may have been tipped in front by Laine, but the Blue Jackets have cut the deficit to one. Turnover, here comes Namestnikov. He's in, he scores! Vlad Namestnikov right down Florida Avenue. Puts it home.
Good turnover caught by the Lightning in the neutral zone. And Vladdy just makes one good move. That's all it takes.
3-1.
Sergachev gets there ahead of the Jackets forward. Laine reaching in from the slot. Birdie scores! On the feed, and the Jackets have cut the deficit to one again.
Great job by Tim Birdie with that shot. First goal as a National Hockey League player on Andre Vasilevsky.
Delay of game penalty. Third power play of the night here for the Lightning. Hedman, Kucherov. Back to Hedman. Hedman to Kucherov. Shot! Score! Nikita Kucherov with his second goal of the night. Another power play goal, and it's 4-1. 4-2. Drops it out to Kucherov. Kucherov to Hedman. Hedman to Stamkos.
He missed the wheelhouse there on that one timer.
Into the middle for Boyd. Backhand and scores! Boyd and points with a goal in 9 straight home games.
That's some beautiful work by Braden Point to score a goal. That one was not easy.
Up to Maroon. Maroon at the blue line. Puts that one in the middle for Paul. He's got a lean up the middle. Chips it back to Maroon. Back in front. Rebound. They score! Ross Colton bangs another one home. 6-2 Lightning.
Now this line has really deserved the goal. They continue to make plays. They continue to get the puck in the offensive zone. And just good, solid execution here on the rush.
That is three straight goals by the Lightning through the middle of the ice. Kucherov gives that one up. Here's Marchenko. It shoots in. Gets his own rebound and scores. Kirill Marchenko puts one past Vasilevsky, who has broken his stick in frustration, and throws half it towards his own bench. And the Lightning are one more closer to that. This is going to be their eighth straight on home ice as the horn sounds. And the Lightning win it 6-3.
The Jackets just could not weather the storm. Tampa gets the victory to extend its home win streak to 8 games. A whopping 11 players found the score sheet for the Lightning, including Nikita Kucherov, who collects 2 goals and 2 helpers to mark his second 4-point game of the season. With 10 Eastern Conference teams in action on Tuesday, the race for the playoffs continues. The Rangers held strong in the Metro, and the Pens leapfrogged the Isles to take hold of the second wildcard spot. The Lightning and Bruins are doing just fine in the Atlantic, with Buffalo, Detroit, and Florida continuing to give chase. Now let's check out the Sharks and Coyotes.
Classic, and now Meyer. That's high, comes off the boards, and they score! It's Kevin LeBanc, and the Sharks take the early lead.
And Kevin LeBanc continues his hot play.
So that whole top line for the San Jose Sharks gets on the scoreboard early.
They need a big response shift here.
Wow.
And a goal! It's Baron Haven from. Picks up the chunk, and we're tied at one.
That's the answer. The Coyotes want it. Baron Haven. He scored on the left side of the net the other night, this time on the backhand on the right side. Tucks it in. Goaltender nowhere to be found.
Yeah, 10-8. The shots in favor of the Sharks.
Fisher's in. Fisher shoots. He scores. What a stretch pass. And the Coyotes have taken a 2-1 lead.
That's music to your ears when you hear that ping. Backhand, forehand. He was going roof the entire way.
Back behind the Arizona net. Nick Bonino, a little drop. In for Sturm. What a save. And then on the rebound, Nico Sturm scores. What a move. What a save. What a goal.
What a nice little move to drag it to the backhand and then stay with it to tie the game up. Terrific goal.
Into the corner now. And in behind, and it's Gadjevich.
Oh, Tripper, he can't get up. He is in a world of hurt.
Back to the line, Ferraro, and that's blocked away. Coyotes looking for a clear, try to help out their defenseman.
Well, let's hope he's okay. That hit him right in the knee, and he's not going to make it to the Coyote bench. There it is right there. Takes that one right in the knee, and that had some juice on it.
Oh, man.
Not much padding right there.
He is going to the dressing room.
Back on this Coyote bench. He's chomping at the bit.
Both teams looking for a couple of points here tonight in Tempe.
It's a score by Nieto. First shift to the third period, and the Sharks take the lead.
Couture and Barabanov will get the assist on the goal by Matt Nieto. The Sharks come right out from the opening faceoff of the period and take back the lead.
Right from the faceoff, and the Sharks have been good on faceoffs.
Carlson, Magna, scores! His first of the year! And it's a big one here in Arizona as the Sharks go up 4-2.
Yeah, the Sharks get a much-needed win at Mullett Arena, extending the Coyotes' losing streak to 6 games. Erik Karlsson collects his 42nd assist, which leads all defensemen and ranks 3rd in the league overall. Plus, Kevin LeBanc gets his 7th multi-point game of the season. And that brings us now to your Top Shelf plays of the night.
Across for his defense partner, Walman, with a good move to get away. Walman in the shot, scores!
What a move by Walman. Just inside the 10th blue line.
Hagel, right side, curls back, feeds the late man, Chernak down low, tip, scores! Nikita Kucherov opens the scoring early.
Early downstairs, let it go for Beniers to the slot, they score! Justin Schultz hits it right on the screws, and he gets a beautiful pass from Matty Beniers.
Markey hesitates, and it's a chance for Patterson, dangles in.
Trying to get a quick start. Here's Pavelski in front, a chance. Robertson, he scores! Opens up the scoring here with number 29 on the year.
Kyrou and Thomas, here they come. Kyrou to Thomas, he scores! That's all, folks. Blues win!
It's time for your 3 stars from Tuesday. Mo Sider gets our 3rd star, recording 4 assists in the Red Wings' win over the Jets. The 21-year-old tied the record for most assists in a game by a Detroit defenseman. Our 2nd star goes to Dawson Mercer, who notched his 1st career multi-goal night, including the game winner, as the Devils came back to beat the Hurricanes. And our 1st star of the night goes to Evgeny Malkin, who found the back of the net twice and added 2 assists for his 28th career 4-point game in the Penguins' 5-4 win over Vancouver. Okay, before we go, check out a particularly star-studded night at Madison Square Garden. Valentine's Day is still a month out, but apparently love is in the air as Henrik Lundqvist found himself in a rather interesting sandwich. Take a look. Between actors Alexander Skarsgård and Ryan Reynolds, Skarsgård gets things going when he grabs Hank for a quick smooch, and then later Reynolds decides to join in on the love fest. Maybe he's trying to convince Henrik to help him buy the Senators. You never know who you're going to find at Madison Square Garden, right? And the game was pretty entertaining, too. Thanks so much for joining us here on the Fly. I'm Jamie Hirsch. We'll leave you now with the best from Tuesday.
Food and thank our Florida first responder.
Ryan Reeves is getting a welcome back to New York.
It's tough and feeding him. It's tough. 38 years old. He's still got it.
Everybody's having a fun night tonight, except the goaltenders.
Down auditioning for their next movie.
Hey, what do you say?
Dawson Mercer, 2nd.
6 in a row.